Aloha. Got somebody from Hawaii right here. Thank you so much. It's wonderful to be here with you here in our nation's capital at such a pivotal time. We truly live in the greatest country in the world because of the founding principles upon which our country was created. I swore an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, twice, both as a soldier who enlisted in the wake of 9/11, like so many Americans, as well as a member of Congress, where I served for 8 years. I take this oath seriously, and it is our Constitution that is under attack today. I first joined the Democratic Party over 20 years ago. I was 21 years old, and what I saw back then was a party that still stood for free speech. That was a big open tent party that welcomed people with different ideas, different backgrounds, different religions, that stood up for civil liberties, that fought for everyday Americans. It was a party of the little guy. Fast forward to where we are today, that party is completely unrecognizable. I left the Democratic Party because it is led I left that party because it is led by an elitist cabal of woke warmongers. They are driven by an insatiable greed for power, and they are willing to do whatever they deem is necessary, even the destruction of our freedom, to get what they want and to stay in power. This is the challenge and the threat behind those who are abusing their power in more brazen ways than I ever would have imagined today. I left the Democratic Party because it's led by fanatical ideologues who don't believe in freedom. They don't believe in freedom of speech, freedom of thought, freedom of expression, freedom of religion, and the right of every one of us to express ourselves without fear of retribution or retaliation from those in power. They censor speech they don't like. Why and how? They say, we need to protect you from yourselves, and so we have to protect you from things that we call misinformation, disinformation, or hate speech, speech that they don't like. They undermine our civil liberties, working with powerful entities in the propaganda media and big tech. They're trying to get rid of our Second Amendment in every way possible, rejecting the very reason why our founders passed it right after the First Amendment. Rejecting the reality that every one of us has a right to defend ourselves and our loved ones, and that we are the check on the abuse of power by an increasingly tyrannical government. And that is what we are facing today. They reject our Constitution that fundamentally recognizes that our freedom comes from God, no one else. I left the Democratic Party because its leaders reject this truth and are increasingly hostile towards people of faith and spirituality, actively seeking to undermine our religious freedom and the spiritual foundation of our country. They are targeting people of faith. You heard from the last speaker and others very real examples of this, how they are targeting especially Christians. They are targeting peaceful pro-life protesters. They are targeting those they deem as radical traditionalist Catholics. Thomas Jefferson said, God who gave us life gave us liberty. Can the liberties of a nation be secure when we have removed a conviction that these liberties are the gift of God? Of course, the answer to that is no. To recognize each other as children of God is to appreciate that every one of us belongs to God and to no one else. So no government, no person, no individual or institution has the right to take away the freedom that God has given us. This is the foundation of the social construct of the United States of America, and it is the core of who we really are. Any political party that is trying to erase the presence of God from every facet of public life and is hostile towards those who choose to worship God cannot be trusted to protect our inalienable God-given rights enshrined in the Constitution and should not be in power. These are just a few of the reasons why I left the Democratic Party and why many people across this country are doing the same. They recognize the great challenges that we face as a country. They recognize how powerful the forces of darkness are. They recognize how the Biden-Harris administration and their allies are taking unprecedented action to destroy our democracy, to undermine the rule of law, by politicizing the justice system to go after their political opponents, foremost among them, former President Donald Trump. What is the effect of this? The effect of this is essentially they are stealing our democracy. They're taking away our right, our fundamental right in this free country to make our own decision for ourselves, who we want to be our next president and commander-in-chief. This is not what happens in a democratic republic. This is what happens in a banana republic. And just as we see in these banana republics around the world, in dictatorships in other parts of the world, there are very real consequences to these actions. It creates this culture of fear amongst the people, fear of political retribution, retaliation, fear that those in positions of great power and authority will use their power against anyone, anyone who dares to challenge their authority. You may remember President Biden gave a speech a couple of years ago in Philadelphia where he placed a target on the backs of tens of millions of Americans who happened to not vote for him. When he said MAGA Republicans are the most extreme domestic threat to our democracy. You hear this refrain over and over. You hear the pundits on mainstream propaganda TV. You hear people in the White House, these MAGA Republicans. They say this term over and over. Who are the MAGA Republicans they speak of? I see a lot of hands going up here. I have the opportunity to travel across the country and speak to amazing, great Americans who love our country and cherish peace and freedom. And I meet a lot of these people they call MAGA Republicans. They are the moms for liberty who are standing up for their children in small towns and big cities across the country. They are those who are proud to salute our flag and express our love for our country. They are those who stand up and defend our right to free speech, who defend our right to bear arms. It is those who have the audacity to say, as a nation, we must have secure borders. It is those who say, in no uncertain terms, there is such a thing as a woman. Let me hear the ladies out there. And there is no greater expression of hatred and hostility towards women than what they are doing in trying to erase us as an entire category of people. Who are these MAGA Republicans? They are those who stand up for the most vulnerable amongst us. They are those who say, no, we will not allow you to sexualize and violate our children in schools. They are those who are saying, you must stop tearing us apart, fomenting racism and hate by racializing everything, betraying Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream for us. These people have cast a dark shadow over our country. And it's understandable why many people may feel hopeless at times, may feel like it's hard to see a way out. It's hard to see how we can combat these great powers that are colluding against us and against our freedom and our country. It's understandable why at times we may be afraid to stand up and speak the truth, to stand up for that which we know is right, and to stand up and speak out against that which we know is wrong, afraid to be labeled as a bigot or a racist or any of the other terms that they use to try to smear those who challenge their power. In those moments, when we are confronted with that doubt or that fear, it's important that we ask ourselves, what are we really afraid of? Who are we trying to please?
Come on.
Are we here to serve and please God, our eternal well-wisher, our best friend? Or do we have some other master, someone other than God that we are trying to please, that we are concerned about displeasing? We cannot be a servant of two masters. So the choice is ours. What is our purpose? Who are we in this world to serve? Who are we dedicating our lives to? I'm so grateful to have experienced from a young age that I was happiest when I was doing my best to serve God in whatever way that I could. To experience in times of great hardship and in times of joy, in times of peace here at home or in times of war in battlefields in the Middle East or in Africa, that when I choose God and rest in His eternal love, I find peace. I find comfort. Finding comfort in God's love when He tells us, don't be afraid, I am with you. It is in Him where we find strength to speak the truth, and strength rooted in love, not hate. Strength to stand up for what is right and to treat others, whether we agree or disagree with them, with love and respect. Because there's nothing more powerful than love. Our hope comes from God's unconditional and eternal love for us, and we know that only that love can defeat hate. Our future and the future of our nation is in our hands. And we, the people, we, the American people, have a no-fail mission. Our founders were talking to us when they said, we, the people. They were talking to us when they spoke of a self-governed nation. All that the Democrat elite are doing now to try to take away our freedom, we should be empowered to know why they are doing this. As powerful as they seem to be, they are terrified of us. Because they know that a free people in a free society exercising our freedom and fulfilling our responsibility as Americans is the greatest threat to their power. We are only powerful if we use it. We have a huge election standing before us on November 5th. This is a pivotal moment where if we do not complete this no-fail mission and throw out of office the Biden-Harris administration and those who choose power over freedom, if we fail in this mission, I fear we will wake up on the other side of this election, speeding towards a country that we will no longer recognize. Now, we might not agree on every issue. I guarantee you every person in this room doesn't agree on every issue, but neither did our founding fathers. They had fierce debates and conversations about things they felt strongly about in private and in public. This is the vibrant marketplace of ideas that is the foundation of a democratic republic. They came together around the most important things, the founding principles of our country. And so the message that we need to carry out as you leave this amazing conference inspired and energized is to reach out to others who may not know what to do in this election, who feel politically homeless, who recognize that our country is headed down a dangerous path, but don't quite know what to do. Reach out to them and encourage them to join us around these founding principles because of the essential task before us to defend our freedom. Now, God has given us free will. In these coming months and throughout our lives, we can choose to hide in the shadows and cower in fear, or we can choose to act and lead with love. We can choose to elect leaders who are committed to the Constitution, putting the interests of the American people and our nation first. Choose to fight the darkness of fear and hatred with the light of courage, love, and respect. Have faith that the light of God's unconditional love burns brightly in every one of our hearts and will give us that strength and that clarity and that true happiness that we seek, and that He will guide us every day, every step through these dark times to the bright future that our founders envisioned for our great country. Let us never forget, we belong to God and to no one else, and by God's grace, we are free and we will remain free. Thank you all so much. God bless you. God bless America. Aloha.